afternoon, sir. Today I will be teaching about the topic maintenance of therapeutic environment in the OT. Okay, how to maintain the environment inside the OT. So today I'll be teaching about that. So this topic is for BSc second years, and this is from Medical Surgical Nursing Unit 30. So let us see what is therapeutic environment. As a therapeutic environment, it can be defined as the total of all external conditions and influences affecting an individual in an illness situation. So in therapeutic environment is nothing but the total external condition or the total external environment which influences an individual. Okay, when the patient is sick, okay, so what are the environment that are affecting the patient with, or what are they influencing the patient, that is called therapeutic environment. So therapeutic environment in the OT will consist of all, the operating room, the equipment, the instruments inside the OT, the OT bed, okay, the lights, the scrub team work, okay, the instruments, all that. So these are all considered under one important umbrella, that is called the therapeutic environment. So what are the rules to maintain therapeutic environment in an OT? Okay, so infection prevention in the OT, operating room or in the OT, is achieved through proper use or meticulous use of sterile instruments or use of aseptic techniques in order to prevent any contamination. So any procedure which is being done inside the OT should be done through aseptic technique, meaning should be sterile. Everything should be sterile, okay? Even the gown or even the sterile field or the sterile trolley which you'll be using, that should be sterile. So everything should be sterile so as to prevent any contamination of infection. Next, isolate the operating site from the surrounding and sterile physical environment. So we have to separate the OT room, and you have to separate the OT area where the surgery is performed, and you have to separate it from the scrubbing area or from any other areas surrounding which is not sterile. Okay, so you have to separate the unsterile and the sterile areas. Create and maintain a sterile field in which the surgery can be performed safely. So we have to maintain a sterile field. Okay, we have to maintain a sterile area so that the surgery will be performed in a normal manner. Next, achieving a therapeutic environment. How to achieve? Okay, how do we make sure that there is a therapeutic environment in OT? Okay, by having these following points. Number one, adequate comfort, adequate food, proper cleanliness, and proper rest. Next, freedom from injury. The floors should not be slippery. Okay, the floors should not be slippery. The instruments should be properly functioning so as to prevent any injury and problem. Next, individualized patient care. We have to provide individual care to the patient. Okay, we should not mix the pre-op patient with the post-op patient. So there should be a separate pre-operative room and there should be a separate post-operative room. Next, the atmosphere should be friendly, cautious, and accepting. Okay, there should be a good teamwork between the nurses and the doctors. Okay, they should be friendly and they should be cautious and respectful. Feeling of security and self-worth is also a very important point to achieve therapeutic environment. Diversional activities for the patient. Okay, because in post-operative rooms, okay, the patients who have performed surgery, they will be transferred in the post-operative room. So to reduce their pain or to relieve pain, to provide comfort, we have to provide diversional activities. So these are some of the points for achieving therapeutic environment. Next, application of principles of therapeutic environment. So there's some principles that you have to follow in a therapeutic, to maintain a therapeutic environment in the OT. Number one is method of vacuuming and dusting and other general cleaning should be done. Proper cleaning, the housekeeping staff should maintain the activities daily, should clean, should dust, and should vacuum the the rooms inside the OT. All organic materials should be removed from equipment or services before disinfection process. Cleaning and disinfection by chemicals that will not harm surfaces or materials should be used. So you should use those chemicals that will not harm the surface or the materials of the instruments for using the or performing the surgery. Cleaning and disinfection solution should be used in required concentration for adequate time and according to directions. Next, use disposable equipment as much as possible. So we try to use many of these disposable items. Okay, like nowadays they have the disposable gown, they have disposable cap, disposable mask, disposable shoe cover, disposable disposable draw sheet. Okay, these are all sterile. So we try to use as much as possible for disposable equipment. So it is easy to use and throw. Next, factors affecting an optimum environment. So some of the factors which affects the very good environment, a very good therapeutic environment, are as follows. Temperature should be properly maintained, humidity, air movement or proper ventilation should be there, purity of air, okay, the air should be pure. Lighting, proper lighting should be there to prevent any injuries. Low noise, okay, the OT should not be like a fish market. It should be low noise, and the noise pollution should be maintained. And lastly, psychosocial environment should be maintained. So these are some of the factors. So you can see here, okay, so the floors are properly cleaned, there is proper ventilation, proper lighting is there, okay, space is there, okay, it is not congested, it is not narrow, the passage is very big. Like this is the OT rooms, okay, you can see here also proper lighting, proper ventilation, humidity is maintained. Okay, this is the scrubbing area where you scrub, okay, where you maintain scrubbing process. And this is also another this is a basin where you perform scrubbing. So these areas and this area, so this is unsterile area and this is sterile area, so they should be separate, okay, they should not be in the same area. Next, steps to maintain a therapeutic environment. Proper preparation of the patient, the pre-op preparation of the patient should be maintained. Hand washing should be performed, surgical hand scrubbing, okay, so like I taught you in the last class, scrubbing process, gowning, gloving, okay, so these are very important. Use barriers such as gloves and surgical attires, okay, so you have to wear the whole PPE, okay, shoe cover, then gown, gloves, cap, eye shield, mask, so all these should be worn by each and every individual. Next, maintain a sterile field, okay, then use standard surgical technique and maintain safe environment at the operating room. So these are some of the steps to maintain therapeutic environment. Next, the principles in OT. Doors and windows should be kept closed as much as possible to prevent any entrance of any foreign object into the OT room. Ward nurse must hand over the patient to the theater nurse with all the details like pre-medication details, IV line. So the suppose the surgical ward, okay, the nurse who is working in surgical ward, before sending the patient to the inside the operating room, she should hand over the patient to the OT nurse. Okay, all the details, the files, the medical, what medication has been given to the patient, if there's any IV line, if there's any blood transfusion to be done, all the details of the patient should be given to the OT nurse. The patient should be shifted to OT always in a trolley. Okay, not in a wheelchair, but all patients should be shifted to OT in a trolley. Patients should remove all the jewelries and should be in an OT gown and cap. Initially, patient is kept in a preoperative room and later, after the surgery, patient is shifted to the postoperative room. Next, OT nurse should confirm the consent form, case sheet, site and site of surgery. Okay, so all these consent forms should be present, the case sheet, the medical file of the patient should be there, the right site, the right area where the surgery has to be performed should be These all should be confirmed by the OT nurse. Separate theater shoes should be worn by surgeon, anesthetist, OT nurse, and assistant. So you all have been posted in OT, so you have noticed that there are different slippers or different shoes to wear inside the OT and different shoes to wear outside the OT. Unnecessary movements like talking loudly, commenting, laughing should be avoided. So they should be noise-free, okay? There should be no noise, low noise should be maintained in the OT. All person entering the theater should wear OT dress, cap, mask, and footwear. Clothes, dress should be washed, ironed, and cleaned and kept ready for everyday use. So you should not wear the same OT clothes every day, but should wash it for everyday use. Mobile phones should be switched off. Any public person or relative should not be allowed inside the OT. So any person other than the health professionals or those who are posted in OT, any other people apart from them should not be allowed inside the OT. No relatives, no public person. One senior nurse is made in charge of the OT in all activities. So there's one head nurse. Okay, head OT nurse should be present inside the OT. OT nurse and assistant should accompany the patient to the post-operative nurse. Next, patient should be shifted outside OT once the anesthetist has confirmed the fitness for shifting. So once the anesthetist has confirmed that the patient is fit to be shifted to the post-operative wards, to the surgical wards, then we can shift the patient. Okay, so these are some of the principles that have to be maintained in the OT. How to maintain a sterile field? Okay, how to maintain sterility? You have to use aseptic techniques. So a sterile field must be established and maintained in order to reduce risk of contaminating surgical or procedure areas. So you have to prevent any contamination with or cross infection with microorganisms. Should place only the sterile items inside the sterile field. Okay, no unsterile object should be put in the sterile field. Opening, dispensing, or transferring sterile items without contaminating them should be maintained. Consider items below the level of draped client to be unsterile. So any items below the level of the hips, okay, or below the level of draped client, we should consider it as unsterile. Like for example, dustbins. Okay, that this is unsterile. Even if there are dustbins inside the OT, and those are considered as unsterile. So a sterile person should not touch such things. Not allowing sterile personnel to reach across unsterile areas or vice versa. Okay, so when you are wearing sterile gown, sterile gloves, okay, you are maintaining sterility. So you should not touch unsterile objects. The neckline, shoulder, and back are considered to be unsterile areas of the gown. So remember, the neckline, the neck area, the shoulders, and the back area, they are considered to be unsterile. Only the front portion is sterile. Recognizing that the edges of a package containing a sterile item are considered unsterile. So the edges of the package, okay, so they are considered as unsterile. Recognizing that a sterile barrier has been penetrated is considered contaminated. So if mistakenly you have touched something which is unsterile, then that is considered as unsterile. Everything is considered as unsterile. Then you have to do scrubbing again. Recognizing that not placing sterile items near open windows or doors. So we should, like I said, that all doors should be closed. All windows should be closed. So we have to prevent and not put any sterile item near the windows or the doors. Sterile drape should be used to establish a sterile field. We should maintain draping, okay? And item used inside within the sterile field should be sterile. Sterile field should be constantly monitored and maintained. Moisture in sterile field should be avoided. So we have to avoid moisture. If a solution soaks through a drape, then it should be covered with another sterile drape. Policies and procedures for basic aseptic techniques should be written, and they are reviewed every year, and they should be readily available in the OT. So all the procedures and all the policies about sterility or about aseptic technique should be there in the OT. So this is the picture where you can see here. Okay, we have to, this is the medical gas system. Okay, where you can see the pipes here. Okay, so these through these pipes, there will be, the air will be flowing, the oxygen will be flowing, the humidity will be flowing, the carbon dioxide will be flowing. Okay, and this is the air conditioning. Okay, and the air conditioning should be maintained inside the OT, electrical and controls. And the in case of any fire inside the OT, then the fire fighting system should be ready. Okay, so those are some of the important topics on how to maintain a therapeutic environment. Okay, so this is about the maintenance of therapeutic environment in the OT. So I hope this is clear. Our main important principle is to maintain sterility or to follow aseptic techniques inside the OT. So thank you, class, for listening today. Thank you.